Welcome back. We're on a mission to find out what happened to the Republic. And to do so, we need to restore power. As a veteran of Myst, I am, of course, very familiar with puzzles where you have to restore power to a place. That's like half of what we do on this channel. And we did get the extra cable we need. So let's go and attach that.
Nothing happens.
Guess we need to click on that one.
You connect a length of cable between the regulator circuits and the junction box.
However, I believe that...
Save, new, replace, delete, replace...
We cannot yet do anything with this because we don't know the correct settings.
Please select an impedance.
Spock? Captain, the wrong setting on this particular device may cause the fusion reactors to melt down. We will have to do some research to determine the correct setting.
Indeed. So we still need a functioning computer console. And the only place we haven't really been yet is auxiliary control. And the weapons bay, but we need power to use the transporter, because there's not going to be any other way to get in there, I believe. But let's see if we have what we need to get into auxiliary control right now. We need to go through sick bay, go back into turbolift 1. And the problem was that this panel was closed. We now have a laser drill, or phaser drill, depending on which description you believe.
The drill easily breaks through the seal of the panel.
So now we can open it.
The panel opens easily. A knot of debris is jamming the gear mechanism.
Okay. That seems to be our problem. Can we fix that?
Initial scans show that the gear mechanism is currently jammed with metallic debris.
The debris is jammed in too tight.
Well, maybe it just needs some lubrication.
The oil seeps into and loosens the debris.
Now, I believe we can remove the debris.
The gears are completely cleared of debris.
All right. Hopefully that means the door will work now. And it does. That is good to know. Auxiliary control. Don't remember that looking like this in the original series. This looks more like it's a mini bridge, almost like the TNG battle bridge.
This is the Republic's auxiliary control room. It appears to be in better shape than the main bridge.
That is good, though, because we do need some functioning controls and computer systems. That would all be very helpful.
This is the impulse power allocation control. Indicators currently show no power output from the impulse engines.
Yes, we're trying to fix that.
You look but see nothing of note. Damage from the battle has disabled the ship's main computer.
That could be a problem.
The auxiliary control room view screen is still operating. It is displaying a view of empty space.
The Enterprise is chasing that distress signal.
These are the auxiliary helm and navigation controls for the Republic. Though they are intact, the ship is in no condition to move under her own power. These are the auxiliary helm and navigation controls.
Same message.
This is the Republic's auxiliary... This is a standard input-output slot for record decks.
Okay, well, we want to read those engineering journals, so that's good.
This is a standard Kirk is dismayed by the damage that was done to auxiliary control. Spock wishes that Mr. Scott were here. Ensign Keege doesn't see the need for a security escort. McCoy wishes that Mr. Scott were here.
Yes, Scott would be very helpful in this situation. Too bad there's no way to bring him.
What a mess. I wonder what we can do to fix this.
We can't fix it. Can't bring those people back to life. Unless we time travel, which, you know, not impossible in this universe.
I believe nothing needs to be said, Captain.
If there's anything I can do, sir, just ask.
I'm glad this isn't the Enterprise.
Me too.
This input-output slot for the record decks is still functional, Captain.
There's actually some on the floor here, too, that I just glossed over.
These are Federation standard record decks.
Record decks or record decks? We'll never know.
Nothing to report, Captain.
These are the auxiliary helm and navigation controls for the Republic.
Nothing to report, Captain.
Mr. Spock, what is the status of the ship's computer?
There is extensive damage to the main processing unit of the ship's computer. It will take several days at a starbase to repair.
We don't have several days, Mr. Spock.
Unless we can find a suitable computational alternative, there will be no way to control the ship's systems.
That's just great, Spock. We don't exactly carry an M5 computer in our inventory.
Correct, Doctor. However, there may be another alternative. Linked tricorders, along with the circuits in the data reader, should have the processing power necessary to control a single starship system.
Thank goodness for parallel processing. I don't know what computers could do without it.
And this was before all the multi-core stuff, they're definitely right. So I guess we can use both tricorders, kind of similar to what we did on the alien ship before, to access a single system, but we still need power before we can do that.
The impulse power allocation controls are functional, but there is no power available, Captain.
Let's take a look at those record decks first.
You take the record decks.
I think these are the ones that we just picked up. Does it say what they are?
These are Federation standard record decks.
Nope. Let's just see what's on them.
Captain's log. Stardate 6087.6. The Republic is currently approaching the Vardane system. Sensors have detected unusual energy fluctuations near one of the Vardanian moons. Starfleet has ordered us to investigate.
I think you can do this multiple times.
Captain's log, Stardate 6087.8. We are under attack by two unidentified ships. I don't know how they could have approached undetected. They must have some kind of cloaking device, although there are no reports of Romulans in this sector.
Stardate 6088.1. We have successfully driven off our assailants. Major damage has been sustained by our warp engines. Communications has reported that USS Enterprise is in sector. I requested Mr. Scott's assistance in repairing damage to the Republic. With luck, we will be fully operational in a couple of days.
Okay. I am betting that was the ship that attacked them. Because we don't know anything about that. I think that was the last one.
Captain's log, Stardate 6088.5.
Stop.
First Officer Andrade commanding. The Enterprise has inexplicably opened fire upon us. Captain Patterson has been mortally wounded. We have sustained major damage to all systems. Impulse power is out. We cannot understand why...
There are no more log decks, Captain.
There's something so incredibly Star Trek about recording a log entry in the middle of a fight. Let's check the engineering journals.
Captain, I have examined the engineering journals. According to Chapter 18, we can run...
Jim, do we really need a lesson in starship engineering?
Spock, just tell me if they will help.
Why, yes, Captain.
Okay, well, hopefully that will give us the setting we need for the device in engineering. So let's head back there. Again, means we have to go through Sick Bay. All right, let's see what you can do now, Mr. Spock.
Please select an impedance.
Spock? Captain, the information obtained from the engineering journals indicates the correct impedance setting to be 19,000 ohms.
Go ahead and adjust the setting, Spock.
Power has now been restored, Captain.
All right, progress.
Impulse power is functioning, Captain. The regulator is fully operating from the power tap run from the impulse engines. We can allocate power to ship systems in auxiliary control. Nothing to report, Captain.
I don't think you can do anything with these panels.
The regulator is fully up.
No.
I fail to see the logic in that action, Captain.
But we have power, and that is good.
This is an engineering circuit junction box.
Okay, no new message on that. All right, so let's head back to auxiliary control and see if we can get power to some systems. Just gonna save here.
Replace previous.
Okay, that looks a lot better. Now that we have power. However, we still need to get the computer working, which, like Spock said, will take both tricorders.
Spock crudely attaches the science tricorder to the computer console.
And the other one as well.
Spock crudely attaches the medical tricorder to the computer console.
Both tricorders are rigged into the main computer's central processing unit. We now have enough computational power to control a single ship's system.
And now we can try and... Oh, what's happening?
Captain, look! An Alasi ship!
That ship was cloaked.
Fascinating.
Is that all you can say?
Captain, I suggest we try to raise the shields.
That seems to be what the logs were describing too, a lossy with cloaking devices. So I guess they're responsible. Now we're kind of on a time limit here, and despite the fact that Spock said that you have to raise the shields, that's not what you need to do. Not yet, anyway. What you need to do is quickly use the left console to allocate power.
With impulse power online, and the tricorders performing computer control, I can divert power to...
Weapons. Shields. Transporter circuits. Weapons.
We actually want to do the weapons first.
Power allocated to weapon systems, Captain.
Captain, I suggest we try to raise the shields.
In due time. Then you want to use Spock...
This is the photon torpedo.
Not on
control.
The buttons, but on this panel right next
Mr.
to it.
Mr. Spock, what is the condition of the fire control system?
Weapons control is functioning properly. However... There appears to be a jam in the primary loading mechanism. Captain, the torpedo loading system is malfunctioning. To clear it, we will have to physically examine the mechanism. Currently, all turbolift access to the torpedo bay is blocked by a hull breach. It is imperative that we get the weapons online.
Mr. Spock, what is the...
Captain.
Yes. So...
With impulse power on...
Weapons.
Oh. Okay, I did click on it properly.
Shields.
Now that we know that, we can divert power to the shields.
Shields are up, sir.
Captain, we are being hailed by the Alasi, Captain.
Put it on screen, Spock.
Well, if it isn't Captain Kirk. Fancy meeting you out here all alone in such a shabby starship.
What do you want?
You should be more civil, considering your Enterprise is far away on a mercy mission helping that poor traitor.
It was a setup?
I can see why they made you captain.
I assume since you haven't blasted us to bits, you want something.
Why, yes I do. It seems you failed to give one of my associates some rather important information.
The Masada, I presume. You want the locations of all your imprisoned comrades?
Yes, Kirk. The Republic's computers will have the data just as your Enterprise would. I give you 1 minute to comply.
Just try and get it. You can't threaten me.
It looks like they're still after the prisoners they wanted released in the second mission when they hijacked the Masada. But this time, instead of just hijacking a ship, they attacked it, crippled it, and killed all of its crew. That does not make me want to cooperate with them.
It will take time. The controls are smashed, and the main computer's badly damaged. It will take hours to get power to the computer banks.
But it would still be good to try and stall for time. So let's choose this option.
Maybe I should just pump a few torpedoes into your shields and check it out for myself.
The Republic will fall apart if you fire on us. Then you'll never get the data.
All right, Kirk. We'll do it your way. I would rather not kill you. Besides, there's an old friend that wants to meet you. I give you 30 minutes. And remember, no tricks.
Captain, the main computer is far beyond.
Shut up, Spock.
30 minutes then. Kirk out.
Yeah, Spock, don't go giving our plan away. All right. So we need to basically get the weapons operational. And at this point, if you try to switch power to the weapons, or to anything other than the shields, you won't be able to. And you won't be able to find out that the torpedoes are jammed. And if you don't know that, the game won't let you fix the problem. And therefore you're stuck. I believe this to be a glitch. I don't think this is like a Sierra game where you can intentionally get stuck. But this extended version of the final mission is not programmed very well. So yeah, it's entirely possible to just get stuck here. We're still on a time limit. It's a much longer one, though. We need to get to the fire control, and unfortunately, turbolift access to that is blocked by radiation, as we saw before. But perhaps we can use the transporters.
With impulse power online, and the tricorder's performing computer control, I can divert power to...
weapons. Transporter circuits.
Captain, the Elassi can surely detect the lowering of our shields. They will undoubtedly try to board us if we lower them.
Spock, what about the fusion power pack? Could we use it to power the transporter?
I believe so, Captain. It would require a connection to the transporter circuits in the main control console.
Okay, that's a good idea. That way we can use the transporter without having to lower the shields. Well, let's go and try that. Means we have to go through sick bay. Again. Alright, so no power here, but we have a power port over there, and a portable fusion generator.
Spock, would it be possible to connect the fusion power pack directly into the transporter power circuits?
Fascinating. It can be done. However, the transporter will only be able to transport a single person.
Do it, Spock.
Single person will have to be enough. Now, if you did not activate the weapons first and look at that console just to the left of the buttons, Spock will just say there's no reason to use a transporter, and you'll be stuck, like I said. But since I did do that, hopefully Spock will cooperate now.
Transporter systems are operational, Captain. Coordinates have been set to the photon torpedo loading bay.
And he is, thank God.
Ensign Keej, I want you to beam into the torpedo bay and unjam the loading mechanism. If you don't succeed, we'll all be on permanent shore leave in an Elassi jail.
I'll do my best, sir.
Do it, Spock.
Finally, they get to do something useful.
I've reached the torpedo loading bay, Captain. It's not too badly damaged, fortunately.
What's causing the malfunction in the loading mechanism?
The inner loading door is stuck in a closed position. Now, I can force it open, but when the loading cycle has begun, the room will lose pressure. We won't be able to beam back here again.
Do it, Ensign. We'll just have to gamble that the system doesn't jam again.
The door is open, Captain. I'm ready to transport back.
Beam him back, Spock.
All right. Don't think we need
there
to do that
no
again.
There is no need to go back to the torpedo bay, Captain. I can assure you that it is unjammed.
All right. Now that we actually managed to do this... Yeah, I got stuck here for such a long time when I was playing this... when I was trying to figure this out, because I didn't... I did the logical thing. I erased the shields when Spock told me to do that, so I had no way of doing this. Very annoying. Alright, back to auxiliary control. And let's save. It's a good idea to do that here. And I can... let's see. Actually...
An Alazi frigate is visible on the view screen. Though silent now, you know it is ready to attack at a moment's notice.
Hadn't looked at that yet. We still need weapons to the, we still need power to the weapons, I mean. Which we still can't do without lowering the shields, so that's kind of a problem. Trying to use them now does not work.
Mr. Spock, what is the condition of the fire control system?
There is no power allocated to the weapon system, Captain.
We still can't do that, so let's just try and contact them, which we use the communicator for. Enterprise is not in range, so I don't think we can even do that, so let's hail the Alazi.
Well, Captain Kirk, I trust you and your valiant crew have retrieved the data I requested.
Not yet. We're having trouble accessing all the data files. Yes, we have. You'll have to beam over and get it, though. The computer's subspace transmitter is out.
Saying that will give us an excuse to lower the shields.
Not yet. We're having... Yes, we have.
So let's
try that.
You'll
have to beam over and get it, though. The computer's subspace transmitter is out.
How convenient, Kirk. We'll beam over, but no tricks. My sensors read that only your shields have power. Lower them now.
We'll comply. Kirk out.
All right. Now we can switch power to the weapons without the Alazi attacking us.
With impulse power online and the tricorders performing computer control, I can divert power to...
Weapons. Shields. Weapons.
Weapons is what we want.
Power allocated to weapons systems, Captain.
Sensors indicate that the Alazi ship has lowered its shields. I suggest we prepare your surprise soon, Captain. They will beam over any moment.
Now we use the buttons.
Kirk, I should have known you'd try something underhanded like this.
Weapons master, fire all weapons on the Republic!
We can, Captain. All weapon systems offline. Captain, the Enterprise is coming at high-speed approach.
Activate cloaking device. Kirk, until we meet again.
Not too soon, I hope.
Watch yourself, Captain. It may be sooner than you realize.
Enterprise to Captain Kirk. Are you safe, sir?
We're fine, Lieutenant.
Sir, we picked up another ship nearby, and we came as fast as we could. It appeared to cloak. Were you attacked by Romulans?
No, Ensign. It looks like the Alazi have been doing some business with them. Scotty, beam us back. We need to find that ship that attacked the Republic.
Aye, Captain.
Captain's log, Stardate 6089.6. We are in pursuit of the starship that destroyed the Republic. Its trail is leading us to the planet Bardane. a member of the Federation whose motives have not always matched the high ideals of other Federation cultures.
Captain, I did not expect to hear you judge an entire culture. I understand the Republic.
I had bad experiences with the Vardane long ago, Mr. Spock.
Fascinating. Captain, I am reading a Constitution-class starship heading for Vardane at warp factor 5.
Captain, its transponder codes match ours.
Sensors indicate it is an exact duplicate of the Enterprise, including hull markings.
Open hailing frequencies.
Okay. Looks like we found the fake Enterprise that is responsible for the destruction of the Republic.
Increased warp factor 8. Send a message to Starfleet. Open hailing frequencies.
Let's try to hail them.
Captain Kirk, this is the Enterprise 2. I am Dr. Iez Bredell of the Verdane Defense Force. You do remember me, don't you, Captain?
I remember you. 10 years ago, when I was on the Farragut, we exposed your unethical practices to the Vardane Council.
The old Vardane Council. Politics is such a fickle business. The new one is much less concerned with trivial concerns. I remember your part in my disgrace, which is why when we began to construct our own Constitution-class ships, I insisted that we have our own Enterprise.
How did you manage to build a Constitution-class ship?
That's a good question. Like the most advanced class of starships in use, how did they get A, the plans to build them, and B, the materials to build them, without anybody noticing? Would have taken quite a long time to do.
You have 10 seconds to lower your shields and power down your weapons, or we will fire. You won't get away with this. The Vardane can't honestly expect to take on the entire Federation. How did you manage to build a Constitution-class ship?
Our intelligence network is better than yours, Captain. How else does one gather secret information?
You are a member of the Federation. You have signed Federation treaties.
And we shall break them. The Federation's interference in our internal affairs is intolerable.
You must have been building that ship long before the Turgon crisis.
Captain, all wars require justification. They aren't supposed to be fun. You have your justification and I have mine. Don't take diplomacy so seriously. However, Captain, I do intend to enjoy myself. I do intend to enjoy seeing Lieutenant Kirk's ship go up in flames. I shall laugh at the sight.
We'll see who gets the last laugh, Bredell. I'm sure you would. You're a fool, Bredell. You can't defeat a trained Federation crew unless you ambush them. We'll see who gets the last laugh, Bredell.
Let's say this.
I have noted that the Federation enjoys talking, Captain. You may talk yourself to your grave. Prepare to be destroyed.
And now we get the final battle of the game, which of course is the hardest one by quite a long shot. Because not only will we face the duplicate Enterprise, he will get some help fairly quickly. And first up, it's a good idea to save.
Save new game. Too many games saved. Replace or delete a previous game. Save new game.
That's not helpful. I don't want to use the death save.
Replace or delete previous game.
Just because I might want to make a save during the fight, and in that case, I don't want to overwrite that one. So I'm just going to delete my first save.
Save new game.
And then I'll save this as battle. The Enterprise 2 is by itself in the beginning. It will soon get help, though. At which point, I've never managed to win. What you really want to be able to do is do as much damage as possible to the Enterprise 2 before it gets help. If you can destroy it, even better. And then just focus on the two ships afterwards. I have managed to do this. If need be, I have a save near the end of the battle where it's easier to win from my test playthrough. Let's hope I won't need it. Here we go.
Raising shields.
Arming weapons.
I I like to start out going in reverse because you can get a better angle on them, but I kind of missed that, so I don't think this is one that's going to go well. Nope.
Ships closing rapidly along with our twin. It seems Bridell has called up reinforcements.
Yeah, at this point, it is going to be impossible. You want to try and focus on the Enterprise 2. But with three attackers, it's so hard to even get any of them in your view screen while they are just pounding you.
I don't know how long she...
This is not gonna work, is it?
Aye, sir.
Alright, let's try and get as much speed up so we can avoid their fire for a little bit.
Aye, sir.
Our shields back. Oh no. There we go.
The Enterprise has been destroyed. Load a previously saved game.
Alright, let's try that again.
Raising shields.
Arming weapons.
There are several Elassi ships closing rapidly along with our twin. It seems Bridell has called up reinforcements.
Don't know if I did enough damage. We'll see.
Wrong shields, Captain.
No, wrong button. That's what I wanted to do.
Lowering shields, Captain.
No!
Raising shields.
Keep hitting the wrong key. Alright, damage control, please.
Aye, sir.
Okay, that didn't go too well, but I did destroy the Enterprise 2, so let's make a save anyway.
Save new game. Replace previous.
Now I'll use the death save, so I still have to save at the beginning if this doesn't work out. Guy's trying to hit me, but he doesn't seem to be hitting me. So that works for me. All right, come on. It's important to focus on the same one because they do have damage control. This is not going well now.
Aye, sir.
Come on. Keep trying to lure me into a spot where they can fire on me. With the other one. Okay, I've had enough of this. I'm gonna try fight the other guy because this is not helping. really know why the battle music isn't working either. But... now it is the other one that's fighting me. Come on!
Aye, sir. Aye, sir.
On.
Target analysis on.
Don't really know which one that is.
Hi, sir.
All right. That's one more down.
Save new game. Replace.
Let's save. Now there's only one of them, which makes things a lot easier. Use my normal strategy.
Engines repaired, Captain.
All right, looks like we might make this. Come on.
Target analysis of.
Just need to get a good shot on him. Go a bit slower. Might help. Almost. There we go!
That's the last of them, Captain.
Well, that's over. Duplicate Enterprise, indeed. That alien contraption was no match for the real thing.
What if the Vardane have more Constitution-class vessels?
The Federation will blockade Vardane until they agree to destroy their weapons facilities and all non-authorized ships.
Message from Starfleet, Captain.
On screen, Lieutenant.
We have read your report on the destruction of the USS Republic and evaluate your performance at 95%. You and your crew received 3 commendation points.
What?
The top brass at Starfleet are impressed. Outstanding work, Jim. We have reviewed your overall performance for this year at 96%, Enterprise. Magnificent, Jim. Just magnificent. This will end up in the Starfleet Academy textbooks. My congratulations to you and your crew. They're talking about making you an admiral, Jim. But for now, I'm authorized to give you and your crew shore leave.
Shore leave at last. I know this great spot on Cameron's Star, Jim. You'll love it.
Where you will no doubt, Doctor, wallow in sensory overload and emotional display.
Well, heck, Spock, it wouldn't be any fun otherwise. Jim, we've got to find some way to get this Vulcan to let his ears down.
Spock, you will come with us, won't you?
I cannot let go by a chance to study the primitive and raw emotional outburst at the level I anticipate, Captain.
That's the spirit, Spock. Okay, Admiral. What are you waiting for?
I've got some adventure left in me before I accept an admiral's desk job, Bones. Take us out of here, Mr. Sulu. Warp factor 4.
So, apparently I missed something. I only got 95%. I did get 100% on this mission before, so I'm not quite sure what I missed. Probably just forgot to scan something somewhere. I'm not doing that again, however, so it'll have to do.
Very few people have the ability to fire up our imaginations and make us think about the human condition. Gene Roddenberry, the creator of Star Trek, was one of those people. He took us where no man has gone before and beyond. He created a starship, its crew, an entire universe, and brought them to life for millions of people. Without Gene, there would have been no Star Trek computer game or a Star Trek television series. Gene Roddenberry, born 1921, died 1991. We honor your memory.
Load a previously saved game.
And that's the end of Star Trek 25th Anniversary. I really love this game. While it has some ridiculous puzzles, it's mostly pretty solvable without hints, especially if you're not aiming for 100%. Although fewer commendation points will make that battle at the end even harder, and Starfleet won't be quite so impressed with your performance at the end. No shore life for you in that case if you don't do well enough. More than anything, this game just nails the feel of the original series. From the pretty detailed backgrounds and sprites, considering the limited resolution, to the music and the sounds, and even the writing really manages to capture the spirit of Star Trek, and makes it feel like you're watching the show. The voice acting in the CD version only adds to that feeling, of course. My only complaint here is the sound mix. The background noise is often so loud that it's hard to hear the speech, and there's no way to adjust it. Well, at least there's subtitles, so it's not a major problem. While the game's lack of an overarching story prevents it from feeling quite as epic as, say, a Final Unity, the individual stories get the job done, and definitely feel like they would fit in with the episodes from the show. Some of them even feel like they would have been worth expanding into a full hour-long episode. My particular favorite is The Feathered Serpent, although they all have their charm. And that's it for this game. But we're not quite done boldly going, because I will be back with the sequel, Star Trek Judgment Rites, in the near future.